I think that period of time is important that we can have most race people in the same school and
Think you're right.
Yeah, school, we're going to be talking, Thursday's lesson is about the school integration more. And that's what I want you guys thinking about. And we'll keep looking at that term that came up in this reading with the NAACP about separate is unequal often. And remember that Plessy versus Ferguson case that you guys read about. Very good, Angel.
Who's next?
Lamont. Thank you.
I feel like that everything that happened and all in that time period was very important to what's happening now, because I feel like right now we're kind of making a difference.
When we talk about the Underground Railroad, we talk about the 1830s. William Grimes obviously told his story prior to that. So it's the first, one of the earliest slave narratives used the term conductor. And I thought, how do we not know this?
I truly want to have the North Shore Railroad.
Yeah.
And I've been advocating for it. I've been fighting. I've talked to Washington. I've talked to the governor. I've talked to the mayor.
Tomorrow you're going to be reading about Councilwoman Rose as a local change maker, and now it won't just be a name, it's someone you actually just saw. You're going to be reading about Professor Page as a local change maker. This is another very recent alumni who is also a change maker. Hi, Kiara.
Hi. Hi, everyone. I'm Kiara. I'm a legal communications political science minor at Howard University, a rising sophomore in the fall.
I saw Kiara speak to the current mayor.
I would always notice the little things, and I would bring it up at every town hall about how children of color are treated. So I brought it up with the mayor, because if I feel like the mayor should have understood, because he has black children, and he needs to understand that this is how black kids are being treated. We're surveilled all the time. They're holding us just for things that they assume that we have, like they think we have weed or they think we have some sort of illegal substance, and we shouldn't have to live like this.
Who else said that question? Yeah, people, Tiana.
Did people ever like try to put you down, say that it's not gonna work out or anything?
Girl, I had so much stuff on me. I have so many stories about that. I was thinking about the backlash at first, but I don't know. I'd rather be hated for something good than be praised for something bad. So that's when I just decided to make that stance.
Dominique?
Yeah, absolutely. Yeah. So thanks again for just allowing me to be here with you guys. It's cool to see all of you guys, and I know you guys are going to do amazing things. Through just my experiences, you're always going to find pushback, whether that be work, whether that be school, whether that's just like within your community, because unfortunately, a lot of the things that we should know aren't taught, right? So we just got to pay it forward, each one, reach one, teach one.
All right, good morning, everybody.
Yeah.
Fahida, so you're going to go first.
My name is Fahidia Imran. My age is 13. I go to Nicotra Charter High School. My issue is to help homeless people because I really feel bad and I really want to help them make a shelter and give them food and stuff.
Who has an idea for her before she even starts her research?
Oh.
Of something she might be able to do to help the homeless as like a service project.
I do. Like food banks, like places where they can get food for free. Because I read a book and it was during the Great Depression, and like people, and we saw the movie to it as well. Something like that where it would give food to homeless people.
Fantastic. So that's another one you could do now where they're distributing food right now. And you could make people aware of that. You could design a website. You could make a flyer. There's a lot of things you could do around that. So Vahida, does any of that sound like a possible project idea for you?
Yes.
Very good. Hi, Tiana.
Hi. My name is Tiana, and I'm 13, and I go to IS 61. And the issue that I'm interested in is the holes in the playground and the safety for the little kids, because I don't want the little kids to get hurt, and I don't want anybody like in the community to think that the playground is not safer anymore. And I want to help by asking NYCHA to start like a little thing in the building and asking people to raise at least a little enough money for people to fix the holes and fix the cracks that's in the playground areas.
You have a very specific goal already, reaching out to NYCHA. You're on a really good track, a really exciting track there. And that's something that, you know, you could get like city council people involved in, government officials. Hi, Jacob.
Hi.
So what's an issue that you might be interested in?
My idea is of how airborne chemicals cause higher risk of cancer.
Wow.
I love that, Jacob. Love the idea, like, Jacob, of looking at all the stuff, like the asthma rates and the pollution and all the stuff like that causing cancer and pollution in our environment. Environmental justice. Sound good, Jacob? See, yes. All the ideas you're inspiring?
Yes.
Very good. Love it, love it, love it. Let's go to you, Samia.
Hi, my name is Samia. I am 11 years old. I am attending to I-61. So what I picked was child abuse because these kids out here are getting really hurt. And every time, like, they try to do something, they're just, like, getting hit at, getting like, really hurt. And it's not really right. So what I say is that they should talk to somebody and they should, like, let it out, not keep it to themselves.
Samia, that's fantastic. Hi, Nala.
Hi. My name is Nyla Farrell, and I'm going to seventh grade. I'm 12, and mine is how people just smoke and not be mindful of the people they're around and the dangers of smoking. I understand if people like to smoke and put themselves in danger, because some people say that it helps them calm down and relax. But the thing is that sometimes people are not mindful of who they're smoking around, and they don't know, they're not aware of anybody else's conditions. So I think it's very inconsiderate that people smoke in front of other people that they don't know their conditions or if they have asthma or anything. I have a question, like, if I were to say, like, how, like, secondhand smoke and stuff, like, that would be an idea?
Yes,
for absolutely. That topic?
Yeah. Okay. Yeah. Make people aware of the dangers of secondhand smoking. Maybe give them ways to try to quit. What are some ways she could do that? Make people aware. Yep, Maya?
She could train, make a change by, like, trying to stop people selling like vapes and all that stuff to minorities, because it also hurts them as much as it hurts everybody else.
Really good.
Janice wrote in the chat, print out posters spreading awareness of how smoking can harm you.
Love it, Janice. Yes, love it, love it, love it. See, this is what it's about. I love you all weighing in like you've been doing. This is like when we studied civil rights, SNCC, Student Nonviolent Coordinating Committee. You get together and the whole community comes up with ideas, even if you have little different projects, and you move them forward together. And that's how they made all those difference back then, and that's how we make a positive difference today. Very good.
Good job. I'm liking your projects, everyone. For all in life.